Good morning, students. Today we will learn our 9th class in the measurement chapter. In measurement and experimentation, we have studied like a fundamental quantities and a derived quantities. Fundamental and derived physical quantities. In the last class, we have discussed certain examples regarding the derived physical quantities. Now, what we said is that those quantities which do not depend, like fundamental quantities, are those quantities which do not depend on any other quantities are called as fundamental physical quantities. Whereas derived quantities, these can be obtained either by multiplying or dividing two or more than two fundamental physical quantities. Now, after this, you have least count. I have given you certain examples in the last class regarding derived quantities. Okay? Now, next thing is least count. What do you mean by least count? Least means the minimum. Okay? The minimum count measurement. Okay? Now, how to define least count first? Smallest measurement that can be made. Smallest measurement, least, I told you least means minimum. Smallest count measurement that can be made accurately with an instrument is called least count. Listen, students, smallest measurement that can be made accurately means exactly by using an instrument, we call it as a least count. Now, we have been seeing different things you are using to measure. Suppose if you want to measure a clock, you will be using a measuring tape. Okay? Now, similarly, if you want to measure the length of a line, what do you be using? A ruler or a scale? Ruler, or we call it as a scale. Yes or no? Now, what is the minimum value that we can measure with a scale? We will find out today. Okay? The minimum value that can be measured using a scale can be called as the least count of your scale. Following, children? Using a scale, you need to find out the least value that can be measured by using a scale is called as the least count. The definition itself says smallest measurement. Now here, in this case, my instrument is my scale. I need to find out how much is the least count of my scale. Now, how to find the least count of your scale? Now, look at on your scale. Let us assume 1 centimeter. Now, again, you will have 2 centimeter. Before that, you will have 0 centimeter also. Okay? Now, in between, if you have your scale, take it out and see. Now, on the scale, in between 1 centimeter to 2 centimeters, how many lines will be there?
Now for this instrument you have
to Josh Recall on the upper one. And here we will be placing whatever whose diameter or length is to be determined, they are placed here. Suppose I want to find the diameter of a cylinder. You can place the cylinder in between these two jaws. Now this is your vernier scale. If you have a textbook, there are divisions on your vernier scale. Like on your scale, you will be having a divisions on your vernier scale. Like this, you will be having 10 divisions will be there on the upper scale. This is the vernier scale. The bottom one, we call it as MSR, main scale reading. What do we call this? Main scale reading. Okay, this is the main scale reading of your vernier calipers. Like on your scale, how do you have markings? The same thing will be there on your MSR, that is main scale reading. The upper scale is called as a vernier scale. What do we call the upper scale? This is called as the vernier scale. On the vernier scale, there will be only 10 divisions. 10 divisions will be there on your vernier scale. And your main scale reading up to 12, you will be seeing. Okay? Now here, this is called as the tail. We have seen. This is called as the tail of the vernier scale. Now you have a knob here. You can move it. Okay? Now when you come to the school in the laboratory, I will show you all these things. Okay? Now, how to find the length of the cylinder? Here, we need to find out the vernier scale, vernier calipers can be least count. We need to find out first. Here, least count of vernier calipers. There is no derivation, everything. Just simply remember, least count of the vernier scale is 0.1 mm. What do you mean by mm? 0.1 mm it is. Okay? Now, count out the least count of the vernier calipers as 0.1 mm. This is 0.1 centimeter. This is 0.1 mm. Millimeter. Milli means 10 power how much? Minus 3. Milli is 10 power minus 3. Okay? Now here, least count of your vernier calipers is 0.1 mm. Now, after finding out the least count of the instrument, how to find the length of a cylinder? Now, length of a cylinder is MSR, main scale reading, plus vernier coincidence into L into C. This is the formula to find out the vernier, using the vernier calipers, the length of a cylinder. MSR means on the scale, I have shown you this, the how much it is measured can be seen on the MSR. If you are able to see 1.8, it is the MSR value. First we need to place, let us see, okay, first We need to place the given cylinder in between the two jaws. Now, you will be having a knob there, fix it there, and then you find out which line is coinciding, with the below line. Out of these 10 lines on the vernier cap, vernier scale, one line will be exactly coinciding with the main scale. Okay? Find out which line is coinciding with the line on the MSR. MSR scale meeda unna reading oka reading. The vernier scale mein the line exactly coincide out there. That is called as a vernier coincidence. If your third line is exactly coinciding, then plus 3 into least amount of vernier calipers is 0.1 mm. Okay? Now if you multiply this value, you can find out the length of the cylinder. Like this, you will be finding out the diameter of the sphere also. Similarly, in the same way, placing the sphere in between the two jaws of the vernier calipers, and again using the formula MSR plus vernier coincidence into L in LC. LC means least count. Okay? Now, this is the way to find out the length of the cylinder and diameter of the sphere. When you come to the school, you can do this lab activities. Okay? Now, note down your homework. Define least count Okay, children, thank you.